Hi, I'm Lil from Made by Marley. Today we are going to be using a wooden luggage tag, but you can use a piece of wood. You can use the back of the wood of a frame and then frame it if you want. So this is what I'm going to be using, good size, oversized wooden MDF luggage tag. We're going to need some air drying clay, some air drying clay tools, some, and we debated whether to use Mod Podge hard coat or watered down PVA, but I've decided, actually no, on camera I'm changing my mind. I'm going to use Mod Podge instead to glue down the air drying clay to the MDF. So for the first stage, this is what you're going to need. You're going to need acrylic paint and some chalk paint to paint it once we get that far. But let's just get the initial design. Now, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on a tier tray. And it's kind of a good size, and I'll probably string it. But what I think I'm going to do is put a bumblebee on it, and I'm going to make the bumblebee out of air drying clay. That's the theory anyway. Might not look anything like a bumblebee. And then I'm going to paint it, and then I'm going to maybe use mica powders just to rub into it to give it some color. I might not do that, we will see as we go along, but let's get started. We'll crack on. I'll get the camera down and we'll see what we can do about this. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do is with a pen is just kind of get my sizing right. So I'm just kind of going to draw, sketch out my kind of B shape, just kind of roughly, just to know where, what sort of size I want, because I'm going to put some words. I think I might put B3 on it or something. I was thought put be kind, but I'm not that. I don't think you should be kind. Of course you should, but so I'm going to just kind of roughly, and it is just roughly, sort of kind of get an idea of where. Now his legs are kind of fuzzy. I don't want you to be judging me on this. I think I'll put that up there. I'm going to have the wings coming down here. Done with moving them over a bit. Just move it over a wee bit here. Yeah, that looks about right. And then yeah, doesn't exactly have to be symmetrical, and some little feet coming out here. And then I'm just gonna put his antennae there. So something like this. So I don't know if you can see that, but that's just so you know where you're putting the clay down onto the piece. I'm going to start with the body first of all. Best to always keep your air dry clay in a plastic bag so it doesn't dry out, because it dries out. And this room is very warm, so especially in this kind of room. Now, I kind of like to work with mine first just for a minute. It's not like polymer clay that you need to season or do anything like that with. Now, we should be able to get this together pretty quickly. But I'm not going to talk from much more now, because I'll speed up this footage, making it less arduous for everybody. that's what I did to stick the bee on. Now the bee is on with the paper clay, the self-hardening clay, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to let it dry, but I'm going to kind of rush on the drying process. I'm going to put it just on near some heat. But what I'm going to do before that is, it's not the hard coat Mod Podge, it's just the ordinary one, and I'm going to give it a little coat of this, just to kind of strengthen it even more than it would have been. Now my plan is, once this is dry, is to paint the whole thing and the bee and the luggage tag in white chalk paint, because then from then on we'll decide whether we are putting colour on with makeup powders or whether we're painting them on. Or I really need to see it dry first before I kind of make that final decision. And while this is drying, I'm going to measure this out and go and cut some words out on my silhouette. If you don't have a silhouette cameo machine, you can just use a stencil, or you can hand write the words. And if you don't have any paper clay, you could just draw a bee onto a piece of wood and do a nice sort of spring kind of, like, I think there's something spring like about, you know, like the flowers and the bees and everything. So I didn't want to do a flowery one, and I thought bee, and I've got a few bee items in my kitchen. And as I said, I'm gonna put this on my tiered tray when it's done. So hopefully should be quite good now, and hopefully that hasn't filled in too much of the texture, that glue, for where we're going to paint. So I'll go away and do my words for this while this dries out, and then we will get back together in a wee while when it's dry, and we'll be ready for the chalk painting. And if you're liking this video so far, please don't forget to subscribe. And if you really like it and you think somebody else would like to make this, feel free to share it. So, off camera, once the bee had dried, it's not dried, what happens is with paper clay is it kind of forms a skin, so it's hard enough that you can paint over the top of it. So I then give it a good coat with Rust-Oleum chalky finish furniture paint in an antique white. So I then got some sandpaper and just ran it around the edges just to give it that sort of shabby feel. And now we're gonna paint it. So I have a little bit of Autumn Yellow from Art Discount, because that's the paint brand I buy. I've got some of this on hold, I don't know if I'll need it, some Buff Titanium. And a little bit of Burnt Umber, dark brown. And on hand I have some black. I might not need the black or the Buff Titanium, so I'm just setting them to the side right now. And what I'm gonna do, my intention is to kind of water down my paint almost like a sort of watercolor, so it kind of goes into the kind of detail that I painted. Now, I don't want too much on my brush because I don't want it to run everywhere onto the white really, but we can touch it up if it does. So starting to put some colour on it first of all, and we can always thicken it up. Like that. My apologies if there's a lot of noise in the background. I do need the black. My children are at home obviously because of homeschool right now in Scotland. The children are not at school, so they are supposedly, allegedly being homeschooled, but it seems like there's quite a lot of noise going on through there. I'm probably going to have to do two coats of each one of the colours because they're quite, I'm watering them down. I'm going to put a little bit of, just brush over this, some of the black as well. Like on top. Just need to check that you can still see it on camera. So that depending on what angle you see it from, there aren't any. I'm just going to do all of the colour in this colour first, and then we'll put that on a bit thick. I'm just going to dip a wee bit in the brown because it's a little bit always put it on lighter and then darken it up, but if you put it on too dark, I don't want this to look too heavy. So by putting all that texture in that we did when you make your bee, your paper clay, it should be that it's quite easy to paint. You know, you've got it all ready, and it's, you know, the tone is underneath it. So you're just adding, you know, into your layers, and it'll sit nice in the paint into the cracks of where you've put all the details. So it should be quite easy to paint. I'm not so happy with here. I think it's came out a little bit light, and I'm just gonna, no, you can't really see this. I'm just kind of going down here just so it looks like it's actually stuck to the cardboard and there's no onto the MDF board. I just didn't want to do this in the beginning with the watery paint because it would have ran right onto the white. I mean, if it does run onto the white, you can fix it. And I'll just come round and I'll do this side here as well. I'm sure you're not getting a fantastic angle, but I'll put it back down in a minute. So this was really kind of simple to make. If you're not great at modelling a bee, you could model a picture of, like, you could do a heart, or you could do some flowers, or, you know, you can do all sorts of things. But if you look at some pictures of, like, just have a look, go on to Pinterest and just look at some photos of bees or some illustrations of bees, and just pick something that you think you can simply model, and then there's, you know, there's really not too much room for error after that. I mean, you saw how I did it. I put it on in sections, you know, starting with the body and then the antennae, and then I built it up as I went along. Now that's kind of bright, so what I'm going to do when this dries is I'm going to run across that way and put some texture into it. And this last bit here, he's got kind of grey, black, some brown. I think I'm going to mix a kind of watery, whitey, sort of really light, kind of silvery grey up for his wings. And go right around here like this. Just trying to make sure that I cover it all. And then I'll go here. his legs, and I'm going to do sort of a browny sort of colour. A bit more brown in there. Off camera, I've just got little bits of each colour now. How I mix my paint is I just get an old plate, and I just, this is how I mix up paint, and then I've got a little, I can dab a little bit of like the brown here, a little bit of the black, a little bit of the yellow, so that it's kind of like a good sort of mix of colours, and then I just hit upon one that I kind of like. Trick is not to rub too much black anywhere. Loving the detail of it. It was really good putting all that, carving all the detailing with a little clay tool, because it really has given it a whole load more dimension. You just need to make sure that you do your size just so that it grounds it and it's, you know, on the piece as opposed to a piece sitting on a piece of wood. And I'm kind of making this be up as I go along now. And the last bit is the when this is finished, I'm going to give it a coat of hard coat podge, and then maybe a coat of acrylic varnish, just because, you know, just to keep it kind of all contained. Just the same sort of deal. I'm hoping that the camera angles are not perfect for you to see what I'm doing, but I'm basically just painting in the legs, kind of around the joints here, just to join it up. You don't need to be a fantastic painter to do this either. I mean, it's, once you've got your B down and if you put your texture in it, it's just pretty much like painting by numbers. I think maybe if I had to do this again, I think I'd make my wings slightly bigger. They're a wee bit big. I mean, a wee bit small for the rest of them, but white out to mix up a watery grey. Just turn it this way just for a minute. I know you're not seeing it, but I don't see it on this edge as well, so that like it because it's not, I haven't painted it really harshly, you know, I haven't put a really jet black on it. And I think that's the kind of secret to doing, when you put texture in things, the secret is to just, you know, like water your paint down, because the heavy paint just kind of eradicates any like depth that you have or you've pushed into the clay, whereas a watery paint is good for doing something like this, because it sits in all of the recesses that you've pushed into the clay and it makes it good. Now you can give it a wee bit white back. I'm just going to do that here and here, just so it's, I'm going to just get this grey and I'm just going to put it up there. Put it on there. I'm just running the grey across here just to give it some tone. Try and extend this fuzzy line a little bit, because I think this fuzzy line should be fuzzier and I haven't maybe done it as quite as thick as I should have done. So we'll do this. And I'll maybe just do it on the, up here as well. Gives it a kind of watery colour look. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to highlight some of this grey and do the bum there. There. So I'm going to call him good. There's a little bit there with that I'll have to touch up with chalk paint. I don't know if you can see, I've slightly touched it. But this is the bee. And I'll give you a close up when I finish it. I'm just going to get this chalk paint that I just told you about and just touch that bit up, because then I know there's no errors on it. Right, done. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put some words on it. And as I said before, I'm not going to do be happy. I think I'm going to do be free, because at the end of the day, who doesn't want to be free? Now, earlier on, I got my silhouette and I cut out with a sort of quite a serious font. Didn't go for a farmhouse font. I like this font. I think it's called Spotlight MT. I'm not quite sure, but I like it. It's quite traditional. Sorry. So there's B and this is free. Now I just eyeballed this and I suddenly had a horrible thing. Maybe I shouldn't have done this on camera. I'm slightly concerned that it won't fit, but normally when I kind of eyeball things, I just, it works out right. So I'm hoping that this is the case today. So there we have it, be free. And I might have to stop the camera because I didn't really think ahead to see if I had. If I had a piece of transfer tape, I do. I'll just get this bit off. Just get it off camera. Okay. So, we're going to want our clean surface. So if you don't have a silhouette, you can use stamps. You can stencil your words on, or you can just check on top while I'm trying to say it. There it is. That's about right. Or you can just freehand it, draw it in pencil first. That way you can rub it out, and then just draw your outline first of how you want it to look, and then paint it in with. What I would recommend is an acrylic paint pen, and that way your lines will be really crisp. Or you could just draw it with a thicker acrylic paint pen if you wanted. It depends what kind of look you're going for. I thought I would. I was looking for something kind of farmhousey but kind of traditional. Whoops, I've taken off my re and not my f. It's a bit of a bloody piece of transfer tape, to be honest. Now this looks like it's just going to fit in no more. Put it down the bottom like that. There we are now. Be free. Now, I have a little bit of an idea, and I don't know, because I think it's looking pretty crisp. I was going back to those the micas, and I was wondering whether I could get a dark brown sort of mica, dip it in with a brush and dry it, and just kind of dirty it up round, like, you know, like an antique and dust or something. So I have got many colours of micas. So let me just have I don't want a burnt orange or a rose gold. Let me see what colours I've got here. Chestnut, don't want that. Red gold, no. Coffee milk. I'm looking for something dark. Chestnut's not dark enough. Gunmetal. I'm going to try this gunmetal. Now, I have never done this before, so this could be where it all goes horribly wrong and I have to repaint it. I'm just going to put a little teeny bit on my palette, I think. And then I can kind of dust off. I'm thinking of what kind of brush I might want to use. I want something kind of rough but soft, so I'll think of all this right now. Going to tip a little bit this onto my palette. So these mica powders are generally used in sort of resin pouring. You can paint with them, but I've not done this before, so let's see if it works. It's kind of giving it a dusty look, but I've got a sneaky suspicion when I blow it that it'll just all blow away. Because I've never done this before, I'm wondering whether I'm maybe putting a tiny little bit of water in it, but I'm going to be bold and see, put a little bit of water and see what happens. Maybe not enough water. Now it's coming on like paint, and I'm not really wanting that. Now I've not done that, maybe better just go up round here. Do you ever think unintended consequences if I had just left enough alone? But I do like that. I think that gives it a kind of an aged look that it didn't have before. Now I've got the bug now. I'm thinking whether I might get some. No, I won't. That'll just ruin it. I was considering putting some gold on it. Now, the last thing to do is put a piece of string through the top. Now, I want my string quite thick, so I'm just going to double it up. I hope you've enjoyed this today. I'm Lel. I'm made by Marley. We sell craft blanks, and most videos are about me either showing you what to do or how to turn something into something. You don't necessarily need our craft blanks to do it. I'm repurposing things with a craft blank, or I'm just trying out new crafts. And you know, recently I've been trying out doing some resin and some wool. So all these different things are on this channel. when I started YouTube's doesn't help because it was at Christmas time and all my videos are, most of my playlist is Christmas, but I'm starting to kind of get other ones now. I'm going to move this plate out of the way. I'm wanting to try and get it in a sort of knot like that. And then what I think I might do is, I'm just going to do this, I'm going to move the camera back a wee bit so that you can see it better. I'm going to get my tool for my silhouette, my weeding tool, and I'm just going to fray the ends to make it look like, and I might put some of that mica on it just to kind of dirty the string a little bit. So I'm just fraying the ends like that. And I'll just get some of that and dirty up the string a wee bit. I'm going to dip a wee bit in the black. Just to the other side. You can't see, but it helps if I've got it on camera. There. I just need a little bit more than that. I just really want it to look like it's not so new. There we are. Right. I'm going to turn this piece of cardboard because it's not that white. I'll put it here and hopefully you can just ignore the fact that I'll just stop the camera and I'll give you a close up and then I'll give it some nice staging. So I'm Lel. As I said, I'm from Made by Marley, and if you really like this video, please think about subscribing, and if you want to share it, feel free to do so.